Right, meanwhile, there are some breaking in bits which have just come in from India, where India's National Security Advisor is meeting with the ruling BJP's president in the national capital. Now, Ajit Doval, the NSA, is meeting Amit Shah to discuss the Amarnath Yatra. An internal ministry note had earlier claimed that the pilgrimage of Amarnath could be targeted by terrorists, and security agencies have already put additional security features in place for this. All right, now for more on this, we are joined in by our political affairs editor, Karthikeya Sharma. Good morning to you, Karthikeya. This is an interesting bit of a meet by NSA Ajit Doval, who's meeting with the BJP President Amit Shah.
See, the issue is political. See, we have to understand that Ajit Doval is not a bureaucrat per se. He's the National Security Advisor. Mm-hmm. The National Security Advisor appointed by the Prime Minister. Like, for example, this position was created when Vajpayee was the Prime Minister.
Right.
Brajesh Mishra was doubling as National Security Advisor and Principal Advisor to the Prime Minister. So he was one of the most powerful bureaucrats. Now, in this dispensation, he is the security czar, and BJP is in power with PDP.
Right.
And it's not only a party position, but it's also the government which is there. So he probably has to brief Amit Shah on this issue. But I would say that you have to see it in the context of the story which we did yesterday, that Amarnath Yatris have come under tremendous, scrutiny from terrorists, that in order to ensure that no attacks takes place on them, snipers have been deployed on the border. Generally,
right.
You know, you don't deploy snipers on the border unless until it is a SF troop or a Garuda troop, or you know, you have a special force rear guard action. You don't do that. But to have snipers on the border is that you are actually targeting people 1.5 kilometers inside, not 100 meter or 200 meter or within the visual range. So I think it's a comprehensive thing. Plus NICO has ended, non-initiation of combat operation. So to create that political consensus and brief him as to what the security will be doing from now on.
Right. That's an interesting point here, Karthikeya. It's interesting that he's not meeting with the Home Minister, you know, who deals with security issues, but rather with the BJP President here. Do you see any sort of political realignments taking place in Jammu and Kashmir here?
I don't think that any political realignment is going to take place. But you see, even in UPA, the security czars would go and brief Congress President Sonia Gandhi. So it really doesn't make a difference. You know, ultimately, it just goes on to show that in our politics, whether it's Bharatiya Janata Party or Congress, power now gets centered with two or three or four people, maybe five people. You know, Mr. Narayanan was briefing both Sonia Gandhi and Manmohan Singh. He's probably briefing Rajnath Singh, BJP chief Amit Shah and
right.
Prime Minister. So I think it's all about that. I don't think the dynamic is going to change. I think Mehbooba Mufti is going to wait and watch, because if there are elections, what will happen? PDP will be routed. And if you go for a presidential rule, it's an indictment of the Bharatiya Janata Party's government itself. So I don't think anything is going to change. What they really would like to do is pursue operations in a hard way.
Absolutely, indeed. We'll have to leave it there. Thank you very much indeed, Karthikeya Sharma, for joining us and getting us those inputs.